This rule checks for nets that have unnecessarily fast edges. As the waveform moves towards a square wave, they contain higher frequency harmonics in the frequency domain. Faster edges resemble square waves. Higher harmonics can interfere with other signals on the board. Therefore, we must avoid signals that have very fast edges as compared to its time period. This helps in avoiding unnecessary EMI and SI issues. This rule can be run on LEDs that have a radiation class associated with it. For more accuracy, we can add IBIS models. Hyperlinks DRC will take the edge rate or the frequency information from the models. Assigning an IBIS model is optional, and we can manually input these values as well. The only parameter that this rule requires is the minimum edge rate to period ratio. If a net has lower ratio, that is, if those nets have unnecessarily fast edges, it will be flagged as a violation. I have created a rule group. I am running this rule on single-ended and differential pair DDR nets. Let's check out some of the violations. Looks like some of the differential pair DDR nets have a ratio of 0.09, which is less than the 0.1 we had specified earlier. And we need to make sure that we are careful in routing these nets to make sure they don't affect other nets nearby because of the high frequency harmonics. Similarly, we can see that there are some single-ended DDR nets that are marked as a violation as well. We can also use simulation to investigate the effects of fast edge rates on the nearby nets. This is how Hyperlinks DRC finds SI and EMI issues for a rapid and efficient PCB verification.